We have a couple of rule changes on the books for this this year. We're going to start with maybe what is the most docile. And this one's going in, so there's not really any voting out or in.
But you don't get an opportunity.
This rule change is simply about free agent acquisition books. FAAB versus regular old shitty waivers. What FAAB means is that everybody gets the same budget at the start of the season. 200 fake dollars. These are not real dollars, but fake dollars, such that you bid on the player as the season goes along. So if I throw $40 out in week one, then that means I have 40 less dollars to bid with. Moving on, week 2 through 14. There's not really any disputing it. It needs to happen. We got Tommy Nog Champa Jimison.
Yeah, let me just put this out there, okay? If I have to kill 11 other people in this league to make sure that I'm the only remaining vote so that FAAB gets through, that will happen. Everybody will die so that I can make sure FAAB gets through.
It's true. So the second possible rule change has to do simply with positions, league positions. So currently there are we allow for two flexes, but the second flex is restricted. So the second flex is currently restricted by being only a wide receiver at tight end.
Right.
The league proposal is to change that rule to allow for a wide receiver, tight end, or running back.
And I think that's
true flex.
Yeah, I think that's perfectly fair because, honestly, a middling running back, who you guys kidding? A middling running back was a combined yards kind of guy who's going to have 30 yards rushing, possibly 20 yards receiving as a combined effort, getting 5 points versus any middling receiver who could possibly do, you know, four catches, 54 yards, something like that. Very comparable. I mean, who are you kidding?
It is actually.
At the end of the day, you know, if you're banking on thinking that you're that position making the difference if that's what your strategy is, please come play me every week. Thank you very much. I'll be in the championship.
So the last potential rule change has to do. This is actually a biggie. So this is a total dynamic shift for as far as drafting purposes go, but this has to do with a keeper. So every year we do our draft, we go through this, that, and the other, but then you get one keeper going into the next season such that they have to be after the fifth round and they cost you 3 picks above where they were drafted, such that if I draft somebody in the 10th round, that will cost my 7th round pick if I would like to keep them. The question is, now jump up, do you think that this will add maybe too much of a wrinkle to the ordinary draft?
I don't see so. One, because it's only one player keeper.
That's fair.
Right. Two, it's... Let's just ask ourselves who we're trying to be here. And I think the answer is we're trying to be a legitimate league. And just like the NFL, we've got to manage our teams like individual franchises have to manage their teams. And you need to be able to make calculated decisions today that are going to pay off dividends and implications for tomorrow. Simple as that. Get real or go home.
That's actually one of his taglines. Get real or go home.
Yeah, I've got it patented, actually.
What is that patent?
Yeah, all things branded and everything. I've got vehicles with graphics and the whole deal, brochures.
Holy
and
shit, do you actually make money with that, bro?
Royalties, yes, I do. Every time that is dropped, that is get real or go home, somebody pays me something somewhere.
All right. So, you've heard your potential rule changes. You'd like you to vote on the link attached. Vote whether to, you know, yay or nay, or if you're indifferent, you know.
If you want to vote truth, just call me.
It looks like I'm Jemima.
Yeah. Would you like some syrup? Do you want some syrup for your waffle potatoes?
Yeah. Some old play at Jemima.
In front of me all the time. My hair is always done in a bun. Please enjoy my syrup. And I always carry it like this. I deliver it like this posthumously as I do when I'm live. I always do this. Would you like some of my syrup?
Yes.
I don't reach out with my right hand. I don't reach out. I offer it simply like this. Would you like some syrup?
I would love some syrup.
Oh, please have some.
I would love to have some.
Just have some syrup.
I would take some syrup.
Notice. Have some syrup.
I have no more hands for syrup, sir.
Of course you don't. Your elbows are far too lateral. If you'd only learn to extend them, you would understand the great ways. Now let me show you a device. This is what I teach all of my seminars in. Elbow motion, right, front, center. Extension. That hand off, it's crisp, it's clean. Please have some syrup.